Hi, my name is Karin Kusma, and today we are painting a fall scene. And today I'm making some swirls because I want to have a lot of movement in the sky. On the corners here, the corners are darker, and in the middle it goes lighter. So now we're blending the sky so it's nice and smooth.
So what kind of brush are you using right there?
A blender brush.
Blender brush?
Mm-hmm. Yes. And I'm starting from the bottom here. So this stays nice and light, and then I'm going upward. So as you can see, there's a lot of movement in the sky. So, and this is what I want to do today, a lot of movement. I got some titanium white now on a 1-inch brush. So I'm making a few little clouds in the sky. And I'm swirling again. Okay, now I'm blending that also a little bit. Okay, everything is blended in. Okay, so I know that I want some water in the painting, so I'm going to make a little water scene here. And always brush from the outside in. And I'm leaving a little bit of a shine here. So it looks like then the sun is reflecting on the water. And a little bit of a black again. And then again, we're blending the water with the brush, with the blender brush. And it's okay when you see the different colors that makes the water look more real. The more colors you use in the water, the more real it looks and not so flat, gives it depth. Okay, now I'm getting me a little bit black, brown, and blue. The mountain now, and a little bit crimson. Scrape all the excess painting off. I think you hear me scraping pretty hard, huh? Okay. Good. Making another peek here. Now I'm blending the mountain, the color of the mountain out to get rid of the excess color here. Okay, now we're making some highlights. Okay, that's a little bit too much red, so that's okay. Add a little bit white to it. And when you make the highlights and the shadows, you have to make it really, really soft so it breaks a little bit here, the color. Okay. Now adding more white. Now it's a little bit more white. Yep. Okay. Now I'm making this here. Yeah, you really have to watch it that it breaks nice. So it gives the mountain some depth. Okay, let's do the shadow side. So, if you're not happy with what you see, you step back a little bit and look at your mountain from further away, and then you can see what you did wrong, or if you like it, or if you don't like it, and then you can fix it. Take a little bit black to make it a little bit darker here in the corner, because this is the deep shadow side. Okay, now I'm making some little bushes here, further away from the mountain and further away from the site. Bigger bush. And it's okay when you go underneath here also, because I'll show you in a minute. Awesome. When you have this down here, you can make instant reflection with the wet on wet technique, and this is beautiful. And then you go across, first down and then across. And then it shows you the reflections of the trees. Good. Now I'm making some highlights on here. And I said this is a fall scene. So I'm taking some magic white. The magic white is fluid. So it thins the paint down a little bit. And then I'm taking a little bit yellow. You can put also a little bit yellow for the reflection down here. Now I'm taking some yellow ochre and a little bit red. This gives a nice fall color. Here too. Now I'm mixing the red with the yellow. And a little bit more white. Okay, now I'm taking some green. Now go lightly again down, or the stroke down, and then very light across again. Oh, I need a little bit more color. Now the other side. Oh yeah, I forgot to tell you. Always put the rounded edge here on the top. It makes it look nice and fluffy. And it gives the tree a lot of depth also, and a lot of leaves. It shows a lot of leaves on the tree already. So let's make a huge one over here. And use a lot of color. Yeah, and don't let the brush slide. Tip it and go away. Or it looks like you blended it. And you don't want to have the tree look like you blended the tree, because then it doesn't show all the nice little leaves you put in it. White in it so you can see it better, the trunk. Okay. better. That's much better. Cleaner. Okay. Okay, and highlight it here a little bit because the sun comes more from the right side, so we highlight the tree trunk from the right side a little bit. Okay, that's the first tree trunk, and now the second one. We highlight that one also with a little bit white on the right side. You won't see much of the tree trunk, but you see a little bit, and makes the painting a little bit more interesting. Nice and brownish color for the fall. Yeah. Sun comes from this side, so we make this side a little bit wider, a little bit lighter. Here's a red bush. Okay, again a nice reflection. Reflection machen. Okay, now we're getting some yellow ochre and white. This is for the highlight, and then a little bit brown. This is our dirt here. use again dirt. Goes a little bit into the water. And that one too here. Okay, now we highlight the dirt. That one already with a little bit white and yellow ochre, and touch it very soft, just like the mountains. Okay. Now we make a couple of water lines and then we're almost done. You use a little bit magic white. Okay, I hope you like it. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.